Hi everybody! All right, I'm going to make this video all about angels, and what I'm gonna do here is I'm just gonna leave it open. So I'm just gonna put my intention out into the universe, and then ask for angels to come in that would like to share a message. Any angels, and then we can just meet some new angels, learn about angels, and we'll just discover it together. I'm a real advocate for helping people to see how easy it is to connect with the spiritual universe and then to experience love from all different angles. And angles or angels, both. So I'm just going to relax, and I'm even going to keep it so open that, they're wanting me to just focus on angels, because I was thinking, you know what, I'm just going to say I want love to talk to me, and we'll just see all the different faces of love, because angels are love, spirit guides, souls, alien beings, anything that is a reflection of love that would like to share a message. But they're specifically saying in this video, we'll just keep it in the angel category. So, so I'm just going to relax, and we'll do this together, okay? So I am standing before light, illumination. So love that creates light, love that creates illumination. What is heaven? It is a realm of love. Love that creates light and illumination. I stand before this love, this light and illumination. I open my body and I say, I am ready to receive love and wisdom. I'm ready to connect with angels who would like to share their face, their style, their energy, their message with us today. So in this way, I'm just now going to relax, and I'm going to be at peace, and I'm going to allow them to speak to me. So when I allow them to speak to me, I just allow them to enter into my third eye, which is, I just clear my imagination, clear my thoughts, and just allow whatever to manifest here. And then I'll describe what comes here, and then that is how I create the spiritual connection. And you can do this as well. So, there's something going on. There's some energy work being done here. I'm sort of in the clouds. I'm standing at a dock. And there's something quite large in the clouds. It looks kind of like the fin of a shark that is coming upward. I'm overwhelmed because the energy is a lot of impact. It's so overwhelming that I almost say it's like the biggest gust of wind ever, but it has no breeze sensation to it. It's just energy. It's really profound and overwhelming. And the voice is male and says, "Do you know who I am?" I say, "Well, I was thinking Metatron, because you're kind of like Metatron to me." There's a really warm sensation I feel in my fingers and hands, and then up here to my, just to my, where my elbow would be. So up my forearms is really hot. I feel a lot of heat here in my hands, and then up to where my elbows are. It's overwhelming. It's overwhelming even in my heart portal that I experience. It's in there. There's something of a flavor of some sort of release of energy from the back of my head and then my throat region. There is a softening to the sensation of energy. There is a feeling of something soft, a softer experience, something innocent, like being maybe 2 years old and walking through a garden of flowers on a sunny day. It's sort of coming with a very relaxed or exhausted feeling as well. It's moving energy. It's flowing energy. It's also speaking wisdom. They're showing me a kite flying in the sky, specifically a diamond with one side has blue, one side pink, one side yellow, one side orange. That creates these triangles that then create this kite in a diamond shape, flying in the sky. I'm holding a string and I'm watching it. It's going higher and higher. I feel like my destiny is to raise my vibration, to explore more positive messages. I feel a lot of heat in the back of my head. There is heat and energy going in here in my third eye. There is a face coming through clouds. It's also coming through illumination. Illumination always comes as white light, or it's got some yellow to it as well. There is also an orangish color as well. It's sort of in a ball that is taking shape now, manifesting. I'm telling you, the energy is quite overwhelming for me. It's really intense. So there's some sort of release of what are like a kite that is within me that has strings and it's being pulled out back that way. There's some sort of energy that is flowing up my feet and going beyond into different regions of my torso. Again, they are softening or relaxing the energy flow. They're showing me sort of like an image of a boat on water, but it's not like a real image. It's kind of a computer graphic, so you can kind of see the waves are curling, and it's got like a Play-Doh sort of look to it. It's dark blue and teal colors, and then has some white surf to it, kind of ocean spray look. And it's just a boat sitting on here. There's a small child in the center. It's like a precious moments looking just cartoon drawing of a child. The child is looking down at their feet in this boat. They aren't looking at the water or at the sky, looking at their feet in the boat. There's also an angel coming down. There's sort of wings, and I can see more of the ocean scene, and it's just stalled out, paused right there. Angel is waiting for boy to turn and look at angel. Boy chooses not to. Boy now is tying his shoes on this boat, waiting for an answer in his life. Does not choose to look at angel. Does not choose to explore a spiritual answer for what it is he is truly looking for in his life. Chooses to just look around and just figure this is life. And if this is life, then I guess I'll just go with the tide. This is as far as you will ever go if you choose to just go with the tide, sit in your boat all alone in the middle of the ocean. There is a deeper need to explore within the heart this charming, radiant reflection that you are, and you can do so, bring that deeper, illuminated aspect forward, and you can do so with the help of connecting with angel energies. Showing me an angel with a fishing pole ready to catch you as a fish, but there is a disconnect here. Because this version is, this boy is not choosing the angel, yet doesn't even have a clue or a thought in his mind that I could even ask angels for help. Now another angel sort of here in my apartment, very small, very tiny hand, touching my finger here. An angel that is like literally like a painting of a baby, in angel form. It's just an innocent energy with wings. It is a sweet and special, caring, loving baby angel. It sort of gets your attention the way babies get our attention in this human world. They're quite extraordinary to just watch. Watch them watching the world around them, exploring things. Who doesn't like listening to babies laugh? I could hear babies laugh for days and days and days. Babies laughing is awesome. This sort of energy is the sound of babies laughing, but it's more that the inquisitive, curious nature, the exploring and seeing the world in all of its as a new thing, with totally new, wow, I've never seen that color before. Wow, what is this? What is that? Actually choosing to explore life as a whole new experience and something you've never done before. This angel, right? It's an energy. The energy translates in my mind as looking like this. It looks like this is also symbolic of what its meaning is. So, meaning is wanting, it's the smiliness that babies provide us, but we also are really quite inspired by babies to just feel a little bit more cheerful in our hearts as well. So what else? Behind it is something of a female with very thick, flowing, long hair, long all the way past her hips. It's got kind of an orangish color to it. Halo over the top. I've always found that halos, my experience with halos is they're sort of channeling God source sort of illumination energy, but also it's sort of coming from the crown. There's something to this, you know? It's like always attached and connected to oneness. You can take your halo everywhere you go. Take God everywhere you go. Take creation. Take love energy. Take spirit everywhere you go. It's kind of symbolic. They're asking us to even visualize ourselves with halos. As human beings, it's quite nice to have a little treat, something that you can perceive as a gift, a part of you that connects you with heaven all the time. You're always connected with heaven all the time, but as human beings, we tend to forget that. And so just visualize yourself carrying your halo everywhere you go, and then allow that halo to channel love and energy from heaven into you, and then you be the angel that channels energy and love from heaven into others. Allow yourself to carry the halo and be the angel for this world. That's what they say. This female is really connected with this sort of baby angel. I'm telling you, the baby is quite clear, fully aware, has an adult mind in that sense, has quite an understanding of everything. It's not the mentality of a baby. It is quite intelligent and wise. This female, though, is with the baby angel. She isn't as loud in her expression. She shows me that what she wears is it's full of color, patterns, and textures. It's got a, it sort of makes me think of animal furs. It's got different squares, purple, black, Dalmatian spots. There's some other colors in it. Just trying to make sense of the patterns. She's not wearing a white robe, is what she is saying. She's quite different. She's unique. She likes diversity. She likes alternative patterns, different ways of expression. Creativity is really about creativity. It's not just about the, you know, superficial clothing. It's deeper than that. It's how do I define it? She keeps saying design. A design of it's, let me see if I can gather it better. Cuz it has to do with, so an architect, you know, they have to come up with a plan. They got to come up with the designs before the house starts to be built. She's really good at helping you come up with a game plan, but also with a creative style to it, helping you to see outside the box and that there are no boundaries. There is no boundary. There is no, nothing is impossible. I'm a huge advocate for helping people to see nothing is impossible, because the more we discover the illusions of a reality, the more we start to realize the infinite potential of anything and everything we put our minds to. She's all about infinite potential. She's quite beautiful. I'm telling you, she has a really soft feminine appearance. And it's really, I mean, it's, she's extremely beautiful. It's not that sort of super hot model look. It's more of divine feminine. It's sort of very natural feminine features, very soft feminine features, not overly exquisite lips or anything like that. It's sort of smaller mouth, but very beautiful skin and complexion, and just and some freckling kind of in on her cheeks, which have like a soft pink hue to them, and then just sort of creamy, like milky skin, and this very gorgeous sort of orangish colored long flowing hair. It's got a thickness to it that also has some curl as well. It's not super boingy curls, but it's kind of wavy, and then has some more tendrils towards the bottom. She really likes to show off how colorful she is. Her hair is glowing. It's like glowing orange now. It's got other highlights of sort of really deep dark red colors and even some blonde or sort of lighter oranger colors as well. I mean, it's all sort of shifting, and it's like her hair is also like the ocean. It just sort of has a tide of its own kind. It's just, she's glowing. She's glowing with natural beauty. She would not go and talk to a plastic surgeon to, you know, up the boob size. Like, she's all about being extremely natural. And she's really about accentuating natural beauty. Accentuating natural beauty. She doesn't wear any makeup. She is exactly as she is created. She does not add anything to accentuate her eyes or her lips. I mean, from my angle, it's like, well, you don't need anything. Hello, you're beautiful. Some of us down here feel we do need something to accentuate our eyes. There's something about this, because she's so sweet and charming. She understands, right? But she really wants to promote that natural is what is most beautiful. Don't be afraid to be exactly as you were created. Exactly. She's showing off now. She takes off this sort of robe of all these different patches of color, just different textures, different, you know, spots, zebra lines, everything. She takes it off and she shows that she's wearing just a gorgeous white gown. I mean, it's absolutely gorgeous. You can see her shoulders. There's some sort of, I don't know what the fabric is, but it's softer and you can kind of see through it. And she has amazing skin. And then it looks like a red carpet, you know, celebrity type, absolutely gorgeous, but has sort of a Greek kind of simplicity to it as well. There's some sort of it's white, but it's got some very silvery type of colors in it, with her extremely beautiful hair, massive, you know, flowing ocean hair. She's like a goddess. She's really extraordinary, like a goddess. It's what she feels like. She's really wise, extremely wise. She's really high caliber. She's really about be yourself. Do you know who you truly are deep down inside? Do not be the face that just is acceptable in this world. Be who you are on the inside. And if you need to experience healing in order to allow that true persona of who and what you are to come forward, call upon angels. I'm trying to gather a name for her so that way we can call upon her. She's really, really, it's really accentuating feminine wisdom and feminine energy, and really wanting women to find the inner power. Not to be like men and go, you know, let's go join the, you know, corporate universe and keep, you know, up the routine of destroy the planet and for the benefit of ourselves. It's really about Mother Earth type stuff and nurturing mother type energy and the emotional soft feminine energy that can see through, you know, people who are in pain or suffering of all different kinds. Women have a natural knack to want to nurture and take care of others. It's really the nurturing feminine side, but also nurturing towards yourself as well. Because helping to heal divine, the divine feminine energy. I mean, you can see that Mother Earth has not been treated quite very kindly. And you can see how society has really shaped women to feel burdens of insecurity and lack of self-confidence and not really shining and glimmering that natural feminine energy that we were born with, you know? It's more of, it's just the linear way this world is needs more of the feminine curvature, needs more of the feminine creativity, needs more of those softer, gorgeous tones that women can provide, needs the nurturing, nourishment, vitality, energy of, you know, a woman's hug and, you know, just a woman's love and a woman's heart, woman's energy. It's soft and feminine and healing. It isn't destructive. And yet women can be so hard on themselves. She really wants to help women to rise above and be that energy that they are. Obviously, we're all unique and different. We're all different flavors of female energy. And some of us have more of that, you know, bullheaded male, masculine style, and others of us are more of the softer energies. So find your feminine balance, because there are quite courageous women in this world, and that too is feminine. Inner courage and strength to be who and what you are is the most extraordinary woman I've ever seen, she says. She's shedding a tear right now. It drops from a very long ways down and touches the ocean water we were looking at. The water feels her energy and it even quivers. This teardrop is full of information. It's love, it's sadness, it's wisdom, it's nourishment, it's motherly, it's innocent and childlike, it's creative. It feels in a deep way. She is sharing this gift of love with the earth. This one droplet of water, this one tear, touches a body, an ocean body, and now it touches all land bodies. Water then goes into the air and turns into rain, now touches land bodies. She is showing me how one tear can touch every human being on this planet. One of her tears can touch every human being on this planet and heal all hearts. She is expressing herself as she's removing her clothing, basically. So now I see her as a divine feminine, just a human being, no angel wings, no nothing. It's sort of like that beautiful image of a woman on the seashell. And the hair that sort of covers her body in those areas, but she's fully expressing her divine feminine curvature and beauty. And she's radiant. Woman as a gift to man. Woman as a gift to all creation. Talking again about linear versus curvature. Men who are sort of straight-lined, women who are curvy, also denotes sort of emotional makeup and design as well. I mean, I'm telling you, I wish I could define what she means by design better, because design of the female body also denoting the design of her emotional body, mental body, design of her sexuality, design of her as a creation, the blueprint of her reflection as a female, radiant female reflection. Really focusing on this. I'm all about balance. So where's, you know, I want to share a message for men too, because I think that's important as well. But the video is specifically focusing on a message for females and women. But then too, it's for men as well. Because men too can appreciate the female design and the female heart and nature. They too can desire to see women healing, to see women finding their confidence. Because confidence is more than just is sexual confidence. It's mental confidence, emotional confidence. It's balance. And men find that extremely, that type of woman heals man. So when women are healed, then man is healed as well. She is smiling, and there's sort of a sensation of it's complete now. Like a sensation of disconnect. I was trying to gather a name, but I can't gather one yet. I've gone through so many names. Give me a minute. I'm going to see if I can come up with something that would be... So how I come up with a name. Names are vibrations. So the name Thomas, over the name Tom, over the name Willy Wag, over the name Jelly Bean, over the name Aphrodite, over the name Ivory, over the name, you know, Sun Blossom. I mean, every name has a vibration. The name Abby, the name Jim, the name James, the name, you know, there's different vibrations of names. And so when I explore the name, I say a name in my head. So I was like, okay, we could call you Jessica. And then I feel what Jessica feels like, and I feel what her energetic design, sort of her super reflection, feels like. And while this seems correct to me, and also I'm checking other sounds, like, could Jelly Bean be your name? Could what else could be your name? Like, could Aphrodite be your name? Could Jill be your name? Could... I keep coming up with the J names, because I was thinking Jasmine as well, because Jasmine's kind of exotic, but she's softer than, she's not necessarily exotic, you know? Kind of interesting, because I keep hearing Juniper in my head, and I just want to see what that means really quick. See what we're doing this together. Juniper tree. I'm going to go with that. I'm going to do some looking on this, what Juniper means. I've heard this before, and I know it has some valuable meaning. And that feels correct to me. That feels balanced to me. That feels alive and feminine and natural to me. So I'm calling her Juniper, and I'm just seeing a radiating sun. So it's sort of like Mother Earth, right? It creates all the nature, and it is the creative energy that provides what satisfies our needs, helps us stay balanced as a living organism. It gives the gifts of all the rainbows, the atmosphere, the rain, the ocean, the mountains, the deserts, the everything. And so the sun image also reminds me of a different version of a Mother Earth, like a mother sun. It's the radiating light that helps all things grow. It creates warmth. It too is like her. It too is like divine feminine. It too shares a gift. This ocean water, this teardrop that she shared, it touches this boat with this boy who feels very alone. Now he's twiddling his fingers and feels like he's just waiting. This juniper angel is sharing her love with him, and her eyes are quite focused on him at all times. She is coming down as I had seen the sort of outline of an angel in the distance that he would not choose to look at or acknowledge. Now I see her coming towards him, closer. She is touching him on the shoulder and then on the head. She is sharing a gentle kiss with his forehead. She is before him now, her eyes looking into his eyes. He does not see her, but that does not... She is there. Whether he sees her or not, she is there, looking into his eyes. She touches his heart with her hand. She knows his needs. She desires to see him express himself, she says. She desires to help him feel how loved and appreciated he is, showing me that mankind often does not feel loved or appreciated and desires that deeply within their hearts. Many, many, many people desire to feel loved and appreciated and understood deep down inside. She understands him. She understands you as well. Do not be afraid to allow my love to enter into your heart, to allow my teardrop to touch your divine reflection. It is a gift that I share. She shows me her arms and then wings opening up like this, and then her radiating light. And in this moment, I am now suddenly, bam, hands against a wall. Where did you go, Juniper? Why is there a wall here all of a sudden? I see nothing. All I see is a wall. It's not a very pretty wall either. It just looks like old yellowish paint. It was probably white at one time and it just sort of got stained. And now I just have a wall in front of me and I can't go anywhere. I'm stuck. I'm frustrated. I want to see a world that's better than this. I want to get closer to you. She shows me that from this teardrop within your heart. She's already within your heart. She is already within your heart. I'm supposed to acknowledge that all who have watched this video, the love of this extraordinary angel is already within your heart. In this teardrop that she shares, she is within your heart. Now her teardrop is all spread all across the land. So there's a message about this, and I don't feel like I'm identifying it well enough, but this isn't just any old teardrop. It's not just a part of the water. It's a part of us all. It's a part of all of us. So, since this is a video we're all a part of, let's work together to figure out how we can get this human being in this room. How can we help this human being see that they aren't alone? This human being is I'm staring at a wall and I can't look around. I'm not able to see anything else. This wall, this sort of paint chips, and it's kind of yellowish color, and it's old looking, and I feel just distraught. I can't get out. I don't know what to do. So I'm just going to be patient. We'll see what comes at the table. So let's ask Juniper what she thinks. Let's ask her if she can come in. She says, "Allow me to enter into your life." Say, "Juniper, I allow you to enter into my life and show me a way through this wall before me." She says, "Where is the wall within your heart? Where are the walls that you are creating that through the design of your own reality? You have designed this wall into your own reality. Explore what is the wall within your heart. Now let us go find it together." I'm holding her hand and we are exploring the wall within your own heart. She says the wall within Abby's heart, the wall within everybody's hearts. We all have different walls that we put up, different ways that we need to explore breaking those walls down so we are becoming more a part of our infinite divine reflection. This world is really good at building, creating, inspiring us to build walls. We are acknowledging this one is an old wall. It's been there for a while. Pain is chipping. Wall needs to come down. What helps the walls to come down? Love helps walls to come down. You have to explore your heart, though, and discover what your walls are, and now fill those walls with love. Love that falls like raindrops, water that covers all things. Water, it has this amazing capacity. You know, it can break down foundations after a while. Water can break down everything. Water. Gentle, soft water can break down strong, sturdy structures. And it saturates everything. I'm placing this teardrop within our walls. It's a healing video. So I'm placing it in the scene on into this wall, which is also a reflection of the internal wall, which is a reflection of the very unique and different walls that we all sort of have created for ourselves. And then I just say love. And I use my finger as though I am this blocked human, and then I write love on the wall with my finger, just like that. Some ego voice says, ha, you think writing love on this wall is going to be good enough? You think calling Juniper, this angel, in to heal this wall is going to work? That's what the ego says. Ego sounds like that. Ego always tries to influence us not to heal ourselves. And that's when you know you're actually healing yourself. When that voice comes in across the intercom to tell you you're doing everything wrong, you have no ability to heal yourself, this is all phony baloney, there is no such thing as angels, that's ego speaking. You just say, la 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 la, ego, I don't hear you. I'm actually healing now because I'm writing love on the wall. No matter what you say, this does work because I'm healing and now you're freaking out. So you just keep doing it. Ego will have to quiet. Eventually, ego always quiets. As long as you remain persistent and you trust and you stand grounded and sturdy in what you believe in is the power of love, then love does break down all walls and boundaries and structures. Love heals all things. This is a very thick and sturdy wall. There's more to it than just this wall, because there are memories associated with it. There is an energy pattern that has developed over a life experience, and it goes deeper. It could be a very terrible, sexually painful memory. It could be something where you just felt neglected and lonely growing up. Maybe you didn't have many friends. Maybe you have just, you know, you didn't have a lot of money, and it's just been a real struggle financially for you. I mean, we all have very deep experiences that create our dynamic, our style, our mentality. How do we override them? How do we discover them? It's a playground. How do we explore all the different parts of this creation, this structure that is now defining us? Juniper is the angel of your design. She will help you with this. She's asking you to look deep. Don't be afraid to see what is there, and don't be afraid to look at what is there. Honor yourself, honor your heart, honor your needs by choosing to look deeply. And if it's scary to look at it with love, hold my hand, and we'll look at it together. So she says. Share a teardrop of my love with it. You have infinite numbers of my teardrops. Share a teardrop of love with it and allow that droplet of love to heal it. That's what she says. I will shed as many teardrops as you need, or you can take one and duplicate it as many times as you want. I am here and I will never ever stop loving you. I'll never stop helping you. I'll never stop helping you with this wall that you're exploring and experiencing and are ready to dissolve now. Walls can be hard to dissolve because dissolving them requires you to see things about yourself that then will require changing. And changes are hard. And they create vulnerable feelings. Sometimes we don't want to acknowledge what we need to fix because now we're going to have to fix it. She's really encouraging this exploration. I'm asking her what I can do to help complete the video as it's getting long here. What can we do together? What can we do together to help complete the message of the video? It's not just your message, Abby. It's all of our messages, all of our hearts beating as one, all of our walls that need to come down as one wall, that it's time to bring the wall down. The one wall. The wall that creates separation on an individual scale, but on a global scale. The walls that create separation, financial separations between countries and diversity, walls that prevent us from being more open-minded, accepting of others who are different, who have sexual differences, different personalities, different learning abilities, different colors. I say, I touch this wall, the one wall, and I say, I'm here to help dissolve this one wall. If you're here to help dissolve this one wall, then let's touch this wall together. Let's do it together. It feels a lot better when you're not singled out as the only one. When you start discovering that there are many of these ones, lots of individuals that are coming together to support a cause that is healing us all. Healing us, our individual hearts, and us as a one species, as a human race, and then healing our planet. Because it's time. Juniper says there are legions of angels that are ready to help everybody. Help this earth, help this world, help this dream to manifest. Help this wall to dissolve. She is showcasing herself as a very strong and courageous woman. The type of woman who's ready to take the bull by the horns. She can be soft, but she can also be determined and courageous. That is the message for this video. So I'm just disconnecting from the work here. That was pretty overwhelming and intense. Don't be afraid to explore your own feelings about angels. Don't be afraid to just see what happens. When you desire to get to know an angel, do it like a child would. Well, I wonder what angels look like. I wonder, you know, I'm going to draw a picture of an angel. And I'm going to call this angel James. And this angel's my best friend. And this angel helps me when I'm sad inside. And James always knows what makes me happy. You know, you take it from a very innocent standpoint, and you know you're always correct. Are children ever wrong? Children always mean correctly from their heart, and they're always innocent about what they do, and they always mean well, right? And so allow yourself to connect with that innocent part of you, and just don't scrutinize, scribble outside the lines, it's going to be okay, and just express yourself. And know that you did it right. Now you can use this video as a tool for how you can discover angels on your own as well. How you can just open up and put an attention out there into the universe and then connect with what comes. Feel it. Feel it, experience it, allow it to rumble through, and sensations, colors, thoughts, ideas. Let it to heal you, let it perfect you, let it help you grow, let it touch you with its illumination, let it be your voice, let it be your caliber, let it be your strength, let it be your heart, let it be your destiny, let it be your dreams, let it be everything that makes you so much more than you ever thought you could be. Let it bring out that deeper part of you and let that deeper part of you shine and touch your life. Touch other people's lives. Touch this world. Let's see your single teardrop touch this whole world. How are you going to take your teardrop and touch this whole world with it? You can do it. All right. Well, that's what I have to share for this video. I hope you found it helpful, useful. Please feel free to share your thoughts and feelings. I think it's a great subject matter, and you can never go wrong talking about angels. It always has a massive way of just lifting us all up, helping us to just feel amazing, helping us to think positively, helping us to feel more connected with that radiating light, helping us to remember about our halos and how we are always connected with heaven and divine love and infinite, beautiful, angelic reflections. We always are. So that's all I have to share for this video. If you're interested in experiencing spiritual healing or psychic wisdom with me one-on-one, please visit my website at abbynormalswisdomquest.com. Thank you for watching, and thank you for supporting my channel.